have all taken a standardized test. We have all had to sit in a silent classroom for hours on end, and we have all felt the enormous pressure to succeed and do well on these tests. For me, I know this to be true. In all my years of school, I have taken many standardized tests, and many of you guys have also taken standardized tests. And believe it or not, standardized tests can do more harm than they can good. Standardized tests can be an ineffective measurement of student achievement based on multiple factors. They cause stress and negatively impact school curriculum, and they should not be dependent on. External factors. This is something that standardized testing does not take into account for. In the article, Pros and Cons of Standardized Testing, published by Columbia University, they explain these the cons of standardized testing and the external factors being there are many people who simply do not perform well on tests. There are people who are bad test takers. They get anxiety, and this anxiety and stress hinders their performance on these tests, making these tests not a true and accurate depiction of a student's knowledge. Another con they discuss in the article is the time aspect of these tests. Standardized tests test you on proficiency, how fast you can answer a question. Because I know for me that if I had more time in the ACT, maybe you guys can agree, we could have maybe done better, I could have done better, because I would have time to fill out the answers I didn't have time for, or maybe check over my answers to see if they're correct. We have gone through 4 years of high school, and we are about to graduate in less than 2 months. Through our 4 years of high school, we have had to pass classes and gain all our credits in order to get our diploma. Now imagine this was all taken away from you because of one standardized test on one specific day. In the article, Why Students Are Feeling So Testy, written by Kevin Clark, he explains that in some countries, standardized tests not only determine exam scores, but whether or not students can graduate from high school or move on to the next grade level. So imagine that you would have to take a test on one day to get your diploma. Do you think that would be a little unfair? It would decide our whole future. Believe it or not, the United States is moving into more testing. In 2002, the Bush administration put in place the No Child Left Behind Act. In the article, No Child Left Behind, A Foolish Race into the Past, published by David Marshak, he states that the No Child Left Behind Act says, every single child deserves a high quality education, and that no child should be victimized by malignant or benign neglect. While all of us can agree with this, what standardized testing has proven to done over these past years since 2002 has increased more testing in schools, which is causing higher dropout rates because it's sorting students based on academic ability. Standardized tests not only put pressure on students to perform, but they also put pressure on teachers to perform. In the article, Student Testing, The Stakes Are Rising, written by Shelby Samuelson, she explains why this is. Students are being forced to modify the curriculum, as she says, to teach to the test. In some of my classes, and maybe in your guys' classes, we have spent days, maybe even weeks, preparing for the ACT. I know in my math class we did that, and teachers are now teaching to the test nationwide. This is explained further in the article, Why Students Are Feeling So Testy, written by Kevin Clark. He explains how teachers are supposed to devote their limited class time in preparing for these tests. These tests focus on numbers, facts, and dates, rather than what teachers want us to be learning or what I think they would want us to be learning, which is how to interpret and make sense of ideas and information to help us in our futures. And many teachers are actually questioning this, the effectiveness of standardized testing based on how they're changing their curriculum. One example is from the article Standardized Testing by Laura Griffner. She says, leaves teachers feeling restricted and does not encourage them to improve their teaching effectiveness or help to close student achievement gaps. This quote is in reference to the No Child Left Behind Act and how that has, and how more testing has come forth because of that act. Also in this article, a statistic from it is a nationwide poll of 5,600 K-12 teachers conducted by the New York City-based Teachers Network found that 42% of teachers reported that standardized tests are not a helpful tool. That is nearly half. And they also said that 1% think it's an effective way to to assess quality of schools and assess the knowledge of students. The second example from a real-life teacher is Molly Miller. Molly Miller is a teacher and also the president of the Future Educators Association. She writes, "Most important, what happens when testing is over? Will students be able to apply this knowledge to real-world situations? What happens when we are learning all these facts and dates, and then we go past high school and after college and we don't know how to interpret information and be teachable and be able to learn?" I'm going to end this speech by stating a couple of quotes that you guys wrote down in my audience analysis. "The scores matter more than the individual. I don't think they give a well-rounded assessment of a person's intelligence. Some people are bad test takers." All these quotes are true and real cons of standardized testing. Standardized tests can be an ineffective measurement of student achievement based on multiple factors. They cause stress and negatively impact school curriculum, and they should not be dependent.